Hello everyone, I am Dr. Tejaswini Desai, Associate Professor in Basic Sciences and Humanities Department of KIT's College of Engineering, Kolhapur. This video is part of activity of International Faculty Development Program on Environment and Sustainability organized by D.Y. Patil College of Engineering, Akurdi, under the banner of UNESCO. In this video, I am going to explain the calculations for CO2 emission in household activities at my own home, and at the end, I will think about some renewable options. So this is the information about my first two videos of activities of this workshop. In the week 1 video, I explained different renewable energy sources like solar energy, ocean energy, wind energy, and the nanomaterial for pollution control. In the second video, I explained the detailed working of solar cell, its types and advantages, what is the conversion efficiency of solar cell, and different methods to enhance it. And then, what is the future scope of solar cell using nanomaterials like fullerene, carbon nanotube, etc. While learning these videos, these are the outcomes of those videos. Students will list and explain different renewable energy sources, explain applications of nanomaterials in energy efficient devices and pollution control, illustrate construction and working of solar cell, describe conversion efficiency of solar cell and what are the different factors that affect efficiency. They will compare efficiency of different types of solar cell and discover future scope of solar cell using nanomaterials like fullerene and CNT to enhance the efficiency. In this video, I am going to do the calculation. So before that, we discuss what is the greenhouse gas emission from different sectors. So here we can see that the major contribution is from energy sector, that is 68.7%. Then agriculture, then industry, and then other. Now remember, here in industry, agriculture, we consider the emission apart from energy sector. So don't be confused that energy is higher and how do you get industry sector minimum, because we know that industry pollutes more. But here we consider all the emissions apart from energy, and so it is 6%. In energy sector or energy consumption, the contribution of 49% is only from electricity and heat. Then 24% is from manufacturing processes and construction, and then remaining is from transportation and other emissions. So now we will concentrate on the energy sector because it has major contribution. And in energy sector, electricity has major contribution, 49%. So we will concentrate on electricity generation. Now in India, electricity generation from different resources is like this. Coal 76.71, this is nuclear gas, and renewable only 16.02%. Okay. So in electricity generation, what is the emission? So this is emission factor, that is amount of carbon dioxide emitted per kilowatt hour or per unit of electricity. So these are the factors. You can see it is 0.82 kilogram per kilowatt hour. So India is third largest country for this emission, greenhouse gas emission. And by signing the Paris Agreement, it has promised to reduce it to 33 to 35% of GDP by 2030 against 2005 level. Okay. Now, when I was studying this emission factor and this energy, electricity used in different sectors. I got very amazing data. This emission, we have the four sectors: domestic sector, transport, industry and other. So this data collected from different cities in India, like Delhi, Mumbai, Kolkata, Hyderabad, Bangalore, Ahmedabad, Chennai. These figures, they change from city to city, but roughly the figures are like this. Very surprisingly, in domestic, contribution is 20 to 40%. Transport changes more from city to city. I have given here 15 to 30, but for Bangalore and Hyderabad it is more than 40%. So I thought, if domestic contribution is more, so it was exciting for me to calculate my own emission for carbon dioxide from my household activities. So this is the data. I am aware that to get the correct result or to come to concrete conclusion, we have to collect the data meticulously for throughout the year, but this is just for one day, and that we can say random sampling. So this is my data: LED bulb, LED tube, refrigerator, TV, fan, water heater. These are the appliances that I use. This is the wattage and these are the hours per day, and the total consumption in one day is 5.028, and we know emission factor is 0.82 kilogram per kilowatt hour. Now I use vehicle to go and to come for traveling to my college, and then I use LPG cylinder, so that calculations also I will consider. So these are the calculations. Carbon emission by electric energy, it comes about to be 4.123. Every day I use about 0.4 liters of petrol. About 20-21 kilometer I travel, so it is 0.924 kg. And carbon emission from LPG, approximately every day I use 0.46 liter. I will show again the data. This LPG is 1.8 kg per liter, and 1.96 liter of LPG means 1 kg, and from that I did these calculations. So total emission is 5.875 kg. It is huge number. It was shocking for me, and again it is rough estimate because I have not considered mobile, mixer, iron, or so many utensils we are using, that is soap, shampoo, kitchenware, purse, clothes, furniture, food that we eat, etc., etc., etc. This is the never ending list. And again, I have considered only the end use of energy, not the whole life cycle of all these components. So if you consider all these things, that will be the huge number. So we can do some little things at our place to reduce this. Just one example I will tell you. Generally, I used to have a pillion rider, so my carbon emission will reduce to half using vehicle. I seldom use four-wheeler, generally prefer public transport. Use fridge very optimally, and everything you use up to optimum level, no wastage. We do not put on the light and fan in whole all the rooms of our house. So by these things we are able to reduce the consumption. And the next option is the renewable sources. One is a solar cell or PV panel. In last video I discussed about it. So these are the IEEE standards, that is Institute of Electrical and Electronic Engineers. This is the organization that has set the standards. These are standards for PV panel. This is for performance testing 1526, and 1562 is for size. So if we use a solar cell of 25 watt, then average 5 hours if you consider per day, so this will be the energy generation, and this is the reduction in CO2, but it requires this much space. We can think for solar cooker, for family of 4-5 people, box type, it will save 30 kg of LPG, that is two cylinders, And then for bigger family dish solar cooker, that will save 30 cylinders. Okay. So these are my references. So friends, it is time to act. Thank you.